You always want a movie to have resonance. And that's what you would try to achieve, a movie with a resonance to an audience. So when they walk out of the theater, do they go, wow, and they, something that they can't put out of their mind. It was a natural attraction to trying to live vicariously through him as an actor. In our movie, we have some of the most extraordinary artists of this past century living in this one area in Paris, creating some of the most important work ever to be created. We have Picasso and Modigliani, and Utrillo, Soutine. All these people were existing, you know, in Paris at that time. It was an extraordinary time in history. When I read the script and spoke to Mick Davis, I was aware of a character already. When I met Mick and saw his passion and his dedication to this film, I felt honored that he would want me to do it.
I first heard the story when I was 12 years old. My father brought this book to me about the life of Modigliani, and I was fascinated because the first thing I read is that he had love for art at a very young age, and I had the same thing. I wanted to write this story because I felt it needed to be told. Modigliani was one of the unsung heroes of the 20th century. And also I think it's one of the great love stories. And the story centers around the love story between Modigliani and Jeanne, who was the love of his life. And then Picasso and Modigliani, two great artists in Paris at the same time, who had different takes on art. I think for me, the quality about Modigliani was that he didn't have any fear about telling Picasso how he felt about women and about life. And this is kind of the running theme throughout the story, is how they respond to women and how they respond to art.
Modigliani is in, for me, in a league of his own, so it's a great challenge for me, or I think for any actor, to try to aspire to the kind of person he was. He lived his life in a very romantic way.
She falls in love with him very quickly.
Absinthe, mon garçon.
I love you.
I love you. I love you. I missed you.
Good. Let's take care of that.
You became the most important thing in life.
When I know your soul, I'll paint your eyes.
She was living for him.
I wanted to go to Picasso. Ask him to hang Marie's work beside his in the new exhibition.
My answer is no.
I've tried to make him tough, egotistical. In the end, you just have to be Picasso.
Wait. I look handsome, huh? Like Modigliani.
There's just no comparison.
You can hang one painting, but there is one condition. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Picasso, a work in progress.
The future of art is in the face of a beautiful woman.
Et voilà!
it's about how they lock horns. One is jealous of the other for completely different reasons.
These were very eccentric times. These people were not woven with middle of the road cloth. They were people that lived their life on the edge. They smoked a lot and they drank a lot. They lived a lot. They painted a lot. Loved a lot. And their behavior sometimes is very irrational.
Voila. It's a very universal story, I think.
I read the script for the first time 3 years ago, and I loved it.
I was genuinely moved by this whole story.
It's just such a well-written story.
I felt it was a very good story to be told, and it's beautifully done. It's a film that's really trying to say something.
It's very strong. It's a great love story. It was a great introduction to that whole artistic world in the 20s, to Paris, to that bohemian life. Just a strong, strong, strong story. And every character is complete.
When an audience comes out of the theatre, I want them all to do the bear dance.
I saw him dance once.
Modigliani's great dance.
By the statue of Balzac.
Because the bear dance sums up Modigliani for me. And this is an artist who was completely free. And that's what makes a creative talent. I want people to feel, I'd love to be there. I'd love to have seen this.